So Sam, will you help me carry my bags? Asked the old woman. So couple of quick, as we go through the questions itself, we'll kind of look at cover certain rules, okay? Which I'm assuming you should know by now, okay? So quick rule when it comes to, you know, if it's a question, right? This is a question. Sam, will you help me carry my bags? So that's a question asked by the old woman. So when it's a question and when you're changing it from a direct speech to an indirect speech, usually you will have either if or whether, right? That's one of the rules that you have to remember, right? And also remember the modal verbs, right? Will changes to would. So two things, will has to change to would. And because it's a question, I'll have to have either if or whether in my indirect speech, which is the option that is giving me that. Option A, the old woman said to Sam to help her carried her bags. Incorrect, right? The verb form is not in the right. You can eliminate option A. Option B, the old woman asked to Sam to help her carry her bags. Asked to is inappropriate here, right? Some words we had, I had established this earlier, like for example, ordered. You don't add a preposition after that, right? You don't say asked to. Inappropriate here. The old woman asked Sam. So again, sentence construction is incorrect. C, the old woman asked Sam whether he would help her carry her bags. Because of this rule, right, we don't even have to waste time. You can quickly, and will has changed to would, right? So it's C. The old woman told Sam to help her. This is an obvious error. So our answer is C. And the commander said, let the gates be left open. So obviously, here again, you know, one of the things that you know for a fact is, this guy is a commander. A commander is definitely going to be ordering stuff, right? So wanted option A, you can rule out quickly, right? But all three, B, C and D also says ordered, ordered, ordered. So what else do we have to look for, right? So let's look at which one is the right answer in this. So A, I'm eliminating, ordered is a more appropriate word, right? B, the commander ordered that the gates will be left open. Incorrect, will as a modal there, doesn't make sense. C, the commander ordered for the gates to be left open. Okay, what about D? The commander ordered that let the gates be left open. So here again, it's taking up the same thing and sentence construction wise, it's grammatically incorrect. So again, our option is option C, the commander ordered for the gates to be left open. Yeah, in fact, I would go a step more and I would say the commander ordered the gates to be left open. See, I won't even use this for, because for me, as a rule, right, I ordered usually doesn't follow a preposition. But the meaning of the sentence is still intact. Even if I say the commander ordered the gates to be left open, the meaning is still intact. And I will still go ahead and select option C. But considering the remaining options, option C is better here, right? But I'm just looking at it from a spot the error point of view and I will delete for there. Yeah, that doesn't make sense. But as of now, our answer is C, given the options that we have. Yeah, just for your information, I shared prepositions not following ordered. Next, my father said to me, will you sit and study at least now? Okay, options. My father asked me whether I can sit and study at least then. My father asked me if I would sit and study at least then. My father inquired me if I would sit and study at least now. My father asked me if I will sit and study at least then. Okay. So, one thing I definitely know is I have will, which means will has to change to would. Okay. That's one thing I have to look out for. I also have a word which is expressing time, right? That has to change to distance. So, which means now will change to then, right? So, looking at the options, option C, I'm ruling out because there's no then. It's taking up now. What about A, B and D? Let's look. A says, my father asked me whether I can sit and study at least then. Okay. Then I have B. My father asked me if I would sit and study at least then. So obviously in A, I have can and not would. So I will eliminate that. What about D? My father asked me if I will. So it's not changed. Obviously the answer is B, right? So if you are thorough with the rules, you will quickly identify the answer. Vipul said, alas, how thoughtless I have been. So one of the other things, you know, when you have this exclamatory words, expressions, right? When you're converting it to indirect speech, it takes up a specific phrase, right? So when I say, alas, you are, you know, you're probably feeling some sort of a remorse or regret because you've been thoughtless, at least the context, the meaning that the context is saying. So what will be our option? So basically, I have to pay attention to the tense as well, right? So I have this alas, that's one. I also have been. So when I'm changing from direct to indirect, what happens? Have been changes to present perfect, changes to past perfect, had been. Okay. Then I have the pronoun, I changes to he. Okay. And alas, you can express it in different ways, right? You can either say, Vipul said, alas, how thoughtless I have been. So basically he is confessing that he feels sorry, that he regrets being thoughtless, right? So you can change this expression to, alas can become confessed with regret. And the only option that gives that is, with all of the changes that we've mentioned here, had been he confessed with regret is option A, right? Vipul admitted that he had been thoughtless. Vipul regretted upon my thoughtless. C is very illogical. Vipul explained how thoughtless I have been. Again, it's incorrect because he's talking about himself, right? So just knowing the fact that when you keep this in mind, right? Certain expressions, alas, will change to this. More effective. The reason why I'm saying this is because you might be confused with B as well. Seems correct. But just in terms of keeping in line with the sentence structure and paying attention to the exclamatory word, which is expressing a particular feeling, right? It's expressing a very, very specific feeling in this case where he is regretting that he was thoughtless. Rahul said, yes, I am mistaken. So quickly paying attention to the tense, right? Again, we know that I changes to he and am, simple present changes to simple past, which is what was. So let's look at which is the option that gives me that. Rahul admitted that I was mistaken. Incorrect. He was the one who is mistaken, right? Rahul said that he was on mistakes. Grammatically incorrect. Logically doesn't make sense, right? Rahul said that he is mistaken. But am is not changed to the right tense, right? It's still in present tense. So you can eliminate C. Answer is D. Rahul admitted that I changed to he, am changed to was. D.